Hello there, Ray here, and we got a brand new snapshot for this week, which is 19W40A. This is the first snapshot that came out after Minecon, where they released what else is going to be added to 1.15, as well as gave out the new 1.16 main theme for the update, which is going to be the Nether update. You guys also asked what is the whole story about 1.17, and the thing is, when it comes to the biomes such as the mountain biome, which they're going to update eventually, they're not going to do it in 1.15 or 1.16. They're actually going to do it in a future version like 1.17 or even one beyond that. Now, the same thing goes with pigmen. They're not going to remove the pigmen. They're not going to retexture them or anything. They're just going to rename them. So maybe instead of like zombie pigmen, they're going to name them zombie piglings. And then they're going to add that new pigling mob, as well as the new pigling beast. Now, another question you guys had is, you're saying that the glowstone that they showed in those images during Minecon is not actually glowstone, but a new type of block. To me, they look so similar. If they are a new type of block, they did a very poor job at doing it, or just a slightly retextured glowstone, as they look almost completely the same, like 90% the same block. That's not like Minecraft to go ahead and just add a new block that make it super similar. But they did go ahead and come up with two different types of kind of soul sand blocks. But I'm guessing the new kind of soul sand looking block that you can see in the last video is probably going to have different properties than the first one. Where when it comes to light sources, they're both putting off light. So I don't know how many different features it can have to be different than glowstone. So hopefully that kind of clears up any confusion with the Minecon event. And if you guys are wondering what all went down with Minecon and some of the new blocks and stuff that they introduced, you can check that out in my previous video, which I'll also link below. Now in this snapshot, they came out with a couple new features, but it's mostly bug fixes. As we've seen in the previous snapshot, a lot of those rendering issues were still in the game. So hopefully in this snapshot review, we don't see any more of those. If you guys do enjoy these snapshot review videos, be sure to go ahead and leave a like. Now let's get into everything that is new about the 19W41A snapshot. So they now change it so that you can have parrots that will stay on your shoulder even when you ride other things. So let's summon in a minecart. Let's go ahead and ride it. Yep, parrot stays on. I'm also going to summon in a horse. There's our horse. He should be tame. That's so awesome. Got a parrot on his shoulder while riding a horse. And let's see if I hold crouch. Oh yeah. So when I hold the crouch, it looks like the parrot left when I dismounted the horse. But now he's back on the shoulder. And let's see, I get a minecart. I shift to leave the minecart. I don't get kicked off. But of course, yeah, when you jump down one block, he gets kicked off. I want to go ahead and try boats as well. Hop in a boat, hop out, stays in there, and I want to try Elytra. Okay, let's just see if we fall. I'm guessing he's going to fall off. Yeah, he just falls off when you fall. So you can't get the parrot to stay on you while you're flying. And you can make him sit so he doesn't move around. That's definitely an improvement from the past. They changed wandering traders, so now they won't spawn into really small spaces. Because over time, it was getting kind of annoying. These wandering traders were spawning in all sorts of places, and they weren't really finding their way out, and you'd have to go try to find them and kill them. There was a problem recently with mobs unable to spawn on jack-o'-lanterns as well as redstone lamps. Both these are pretty useful because mobs such as slimes, you want to have a lot of light so they can spawn without other hostile mobs spawning, and also redstone lamps, you could turn them on and off, so you can prevent like hostile mobs from spawning or not. They fixed quite a few bugs to do with bees and beehives. This is our world where we have a whole bunch of bee farms. The first one was when bees were inside of the hive and explosions were occurring, the bees would not leave it. So if we summon TNT, you can see a bee came out of it. Well, all three bees came out of it. And quite a few of these bugs are ones that we came across during our testing streams every Wednesday and Friday. And we'll be having a stream tonight at 9 p.m. Eastern Time, and we may even start a bit earlier. The next bug that they fixed to do with bees is the baby bees. We noticed that their hitboxes were off compared to the adults, and instead of having the red line at the very center, they're having it at the top, and they were suffocating inside of blocks. So it looks like the baby bees are now with the correct hitbox. They also added some new mechanics to do with how the bees act when their hive is under fire, meaning that it's set on fire. So if we go ahead and set this beehive on fire, bees will now not attempt to go back into it since it is on fire. They'll also attempt to leave it if they were inside of it. And when the beehive does burn down, it will release whatever bees were inside of it. So that's pretty cool, more realistic, as this is something that bees would do in real life. So I guess that's one way to try to get bees out of their hive, is you could try to like light it on fire to get them out of the hive before taking it for yourself. But most of the time you want to take the hive with bees inside of it. They also fix it so you can now have an adult mule come from like a spawn egg, and you can get a baby one by just right-clicking it. Before, it would only produce other adults. They said they also fix a bunch of rendering problems to do with the textures of different stuff, so different block textures as well as different entities, as I showed in a previous video, were not quite right. Like the shading was different on the top of entities than on the sides, and it was really noticeable. They also fixed the block animations being too fast, like fire was really fast as well as lava animation, so now you can see it looks more normal. There's also problems to do with end portals, with their rendering being off, as well as end gateways. So if I just spawn one right here, you can see that it's now directly in the center. Last time it was kind of flying all over our screen, which is pretty funny, but also mean that there was essentially no texture for this portal, and it was pretty difficult to find it once you placed it down. It also fixed a problem to do with the animation of breaking stuff. It wasn't actually being placed on the block correctly. They fixed a really crazy bug that I showed you guys in the last video to do with turtles. The turtle hitbox was completely messed up. It was like upside down and the limbs were way up in the air and the baby turtles, their head was like super far underneath of them. You guys might see that. I showed that in the last video. It was definitely a pretty horrorish start to October. It was almost like it was some kind of horror movie, as we are in the month of October. They fixed the problem that we've seen with flickering leaves. If you didn't have your mint mapping turned off, then the leaves would kind of flicker, which got pretty annoying, especially if you're around a large forest. They also fixed the transparent problem that we've seen in some blocks, such as like slime blocks, where it was rendering the block behind it instead of the slime itself. The nice thing about these new render that they're doing with the game is we don't have the problems like we've seen before, where different blocks would show through, so like the clouds would sometimes render behind slime blocks and made it extremely annoying to like build them up here. So make like the block invisible just so they could show the clouds. But you can see now it works really nice. You can see the slime and the cloud is also showing up nicely where it is possible. We also see the same problem to do with like water, and depending on how blocks were around water, sometimes the water would render and sometimes the block would render. The one that was most noticeable is like the phantom. When it was on fire, you could see through the water. So let's try that one out. Summon phantom. Yeah, looks like that's completely fixed now. Phantom used to be able to, when it was on fire, show right through the water. You could easily see the bottom of the ocean. That's really cool that this rendering has kind of fixed all those problems. And it's one of those really old bug reports that has to do with stuff rendering. So maybe that one will be considered fixed now that they have completely changed the rendering. So even though they're having some little hiccups during this phase where they're trying to introduce it, overall it's going to really remove those really bizarre rendering bugs we used to see for the last at least 7 years, I think. They fixed a bug to do with the game crashing when the player was stung by a bee. It had to do with the player model changing. I just want to go ahead and give that a try. I don't know, the model don't really look like it changed too much. I guess it has to do with the poison effect being applied to the player. There's also some rendering issues to do with shulker boxes. And when you like kind of raise them up, they would look kind of strange in front of some backgrounds, such as like water and like these little empty spots beside them would sometimes show up as being white. But it looks like everything is completely fixed, and it looks like they also took a lot of your guys' suggestions about the little outlines they do with pointing at different blocks. They're not as prominent anymore, they're more subtle, and they also made them so they're visible no matter what the background is. So you can see if I'm looking straight down, the little line around the outside of this block, which I'm aiming at, is black. But like here, the shulker, where it comes in contact with this water, it converted over into more of a gray. But I'm not sure if it's supposed to really allow you to see through the shulker box, because that's what it's kind of look like it's doing right here. You can actually see into the ocean. So maybe it doesn't render quite right in front of the water. I was kind of hoping it was doing like you guys say, where it should kind of invert the color so it's always easy to see. Don't matter if it's like a black on black. You should still be able to see the outline, but yeah, I guess you still can't see the outline on black stuff. They fixed a bug to do with turtles ridden by a illager was crashing the game when it entered the water. That is a pretty odd bug report, but that also makes you think, wouldn't it be kind of cool to see like maybe a drown riding on top of a turtle with like a trident? That'd be pretty funny to see. Maybe it's some kind of alternative boss that you can find at those runes. They fixed a bug to do with the text on signs actually glowing. So you put a sign down, put some words on it. Yeah, it looks like it's rendering properly now. You guys also sent me some really funny pictures of like chest and stuff that weren't rendering properly. And the ender chest actually looked kind of cool the way it wasn't rendered, but those have now been fixed. It also fixed a bug to do with banners aren't being rendered properly. And one thing that you guys brought to my attention is you guys said that banners can't actually be made inside of crafting tables anymore. And we did test this during the stream and it didn't work. So let's see if it's still the case. So usually what you need for a custom banner is a banner and then also some dyes. Let's just try cyan. I also noticed that when you place down banners, they flicker white for a brief instance, which was kind of annoying. But what you do is put a banner there and you put like some dye across it and it would make something over here on the side. But it seems that it's no longer working. Now, when they came out with the new type of crafting system to do with banners, which is the loom down here, it made it a lot easier to craft a banner. You just shift click both these in and you can choose your design and you get your banner out. But when they introduced that, they also did not remove the old way of doing it with the crafting tables. But now it seems that they have removed that, which is kind of unsettling because a lot of people were hoping to get the same abilities that they used to be able to do out of a crafting table. Because some people don't want to carry around tons of different toolboxes just to do the different things. And that'd be similar to like the stone cutter, which allows you to cut stuff more efficiently. And you can cut like slabs and stuff up in here, but it doesn't prevent you from also making slabs in the crafting table. So that might actually be a bug. They also fix a bug to do if the player was inside of a block, the block itself would no longer be rendered. They also fix a bug to do with the player rendering too low inside of a boat. So let's go ahead and hop in a boat. And I guess the problem was the player was kind of set lower than he should be. Now you can't see his legs are actually officially underneath of him. And if you were trying to like ride this boat over a waterlogged slab or something, you could, but you couldn't place a slab directly inside of where those legs are kind of hanging down underneath or actually at. Other than that, the player looks like he's sitting there just fine. You can see his legs. Now, speaking of weird glitches to do with boats, I'll give you guys a sneak peek of what we did on the ProtoTech SMP server. As we found ourselves in a situation where we were inside of a boat, but we couldn't actually crouch to get out of the boat, so we were stuck in there forever. So here's a sneak peek of a future episode, which that will be in. Here, hold the crouch so that it looks like we're like running really fast with our boat. There's also problems to do with panda babies, with them not rendering correctly, as well as polar bear babies, but it looks like they're good now. The lighting looks a little harsh on the sides, like the top compared to the side looks a little bit harsh still, but it's not as bad as it was. They fixed a bug to do with the glowing effect actually being applied to the block below the affected mob. I know a lot of you guys were hoping they came out with the new honey block during this snapshot. And I'm really excited for it too. I'm really curious to see if the honey block as well as the slime block will stick to each other. Hopefully they don't, so you can kind of have two different types of slime blocks to use in slimestone, which will make compacting much nicer. It'll also allow you to do some other things as well, which would be really fun to play around with. And of course, the stickiness of it and how it moves mobs is a really interesting feature, which is going to be a lot of fun to play around with during our snapshot testing streams. Tonight, we will be continuing working on the simple shulker shell farm, as well as working on any cool ideas that you guys come up with. So if you guys haven't already, be sure to go ahead, turn your notifications on here on YouTube, as well as follow me on Twitter, and join our community Discord, which is a really great community to be a part of, and you can find links down below. I'd like to thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye!